a couple of weeks ago, we were thrown a bit of a curveball. But tonight, thanks to the faculty and staff at IN75, namely Principal Mr. Canizaro. Our beast of a technical director, Mr. James Wall, behind us. And also our music helper, if you will, Mr. Peters. Also, we'd like to thank some of the Tottenville staff that really helped this transition go through. First of all, being Mr. Johnny Tunes himself, John Tuminaro. And Ms. Tierno for all that she does. So tonight, we come to you as a cast that have been thrown curveballs left and right, as I said before. A couple of weeks ago, when the auditorium collapsed at Tottenville High School, we were obviously devastated. But this cast took it on the chin, pulled up their bootstraps, and got themselves together that night for an impromptu rehearsal at someone's house where they ran lines for 3 hours. Tonight, you're going to see a cast that grew before my eyes. They came to me as nervous high school students looking for a role. And now you'll see them grown into a family and a Broadway-ready cast. After the show, this being our very last show, we will be striking from IS75, so we do ask for your patience. And any parents that are involved or can help us, we do need to get everything out of this school so to leave the facility in the way that we found it. So anyone who can help us with that, we greatly appreciate it. At the very least, we ask for your patience. We thank you very much for being here tonight, today, I suppose I should say. This being our last show for 2011, Tottenville High School's Crazy For You.
Thank you. knew he had big feet.
Hello, Bobby.
Irene.
Say goodbye to the ladies, Bobby.
Now, would you wait a second?
We've got to go anyway. Hey, Bobby.
Good night.
Bobby, it's time we gave up all this dancing nonsense and settle down.
Nonsense?
We have been engaged for 5 years. Now, when are we getting married?
We're not.
Of course we are.
Oh, no, we're not.
Don't be ridiculous. I have the wedding all planned. The guest list is up to 900.
Great. Big crowd. You won't even miss me.
Okay, we start in 3 weeks.
Mrs. Engel, I am so sorry about your foot.
Excuse me at the moment. More
now, I want you to promise me from the day of our marriage to work in the bank.
But I don't want to work in the bank. That's what my mother wants. You see, that is the problem. No one takes me seriously in the theater. Well, I'll tell you something. If I saw my mother right now, you know what I'd do? I'd look her dead in the eye and I'd say, Mother.
Yes, Bobby.
Come on, you look fine that corner.
I knew I'd find you here.
Lottie, dear, I'm talking to Bobby.
Well, so am I.
And get in line.
Bobby, in the 10 years since you've left Harvard, you've accomplished nothing.
You got engaged to me.
You've accomplished less than nothing. Now, the board of directors and I have decided to give you one last chance. If you fail the bank this time, I will cut off your allowance.
When he's married to me, he won't need an allowance.
No, he'll need a psychiatrist. Now this is a deed of property.
Fine, do you have a pen?
Not by you, you idiot, by some other idiot who lives in Deadrock, Nevada. I want you to go there immediately and get him to sign it.
Nevada?
I'll save the bank's water sum for closing.
But who cares? I just want to dance.
No.
I don't care about my mother. I'm so sorry, my mother.
He will go to Nevada over my dead body. That seems like an excellent route. Bobby, get in the car! She is going to be not going to water. First, you're going to run on that. I will cut her
He's not upset, and he'll refuse to fret.
that day.